Today we'll be talking about team performance and conflict management.
Let's go, team!
And the things that we'll be talking about, we are going to talk about the criteria for a successful team, characteristics of the successful team, 5 stages of the team, and the importance of team dynamic. Now, why are we learning about teams? We're learning about teams because no one is in isolation. No one can reach goals alone. You need to have people who are going to support you so that you reach the particular goals or you reach your objectives. So now, even in an enterprise environment, under business studies, you have to know how to behave on a team. You have to know how to what are the characteristics, what is it that is needed for one to perform well under team. Because in a working environment, it's a combination of one must do that, one must do that. So now you need other people. So you are not going to work alone. So it's very important to know what is expected from teams.
What do we need to do?
As I've said that we'll be talking about the criteria for a successful teams. The first criteria that we're going to talk about is interpersonal attitude and behavior. Now, when we talk about interpersonal attitude, we're talking about the attitude that one must have in a team. One needs to have a positive attitude. You need to support the team members. You need to have a willing spirit towards your team members to deliver the work. You have to be passionate about the goals of the team so that the team will be successful. That is interpersonal attitude. And then the other criteria that we'll talk about is shared value and mutual support. When we talk about shared value and mutual trust and support, we are talking about that if we are on a team, you'll be expected to respect, you'll be expected to trust your team members.
Trust your team.
You can't be on a team whereby you don't believe in other team members. So you have to have a respect on their skills, respect on their work. That's what you must do. And the other criteria that you are going to talk about is communication. Communication is very vital.
If we're going to succeed, we need to communicate.
People need to communicate what is it that's supposed to go, the roles that one need to play on a team. You need to understand what is it that you're supposed to deliver for your team members. There must be a good communication. Feedback, it's very important. People must be told what are the results of
work done.
And people need to be honest in terms of communication. And then the other criteria that you're talking about, it's cooperation or collaboration.
Fun collaborating together.
Cooperation is when how you need to cooperate with your team members. You need to respect your team members. You need to set realistic goals so that people will be able to work towards the decision that you're going to take, the willingness of your team members. That is very important under a collaboration. And then now we'll be talking about the characteristics of a successful team.
What is it?
Guys, most of you, you've experienced teams. There are many teams that people were involved in. Once be a netball team person, you once a soccer player, rugby, you were involved. Now, for the team to be successful, it's very important for everyone to play its part. So now, under the characteristics of the successful team, it's more or less the criteria. Some of the factors, they are similar. For the team to be successful, people need to have a common goal. One must not plan on having a other goal, different goals. People need to have a common goal. And respect is supposed to be installed by team members.
R-E-S-P-E-C-T.
You need to respect other people's work. You need to be honest on your dealings. And you need to have a sound relation, good spirit amongst your team workers. And then you need to value each other's contribution. And there must be a consensus. There must be an agreement on
differences.
if a team exists, there must be people must agree on facts, on whatever the decision that is taken. There must be a consensus. And then there must be accountability. And then team members need to pay attention on the needs of each and every team member. Now that we've talked about the criteria for a successful teams and we've talked about the characteristics of the successful teams, now we've got a little bit of an assessment that I want you to do it so that you check how well have you understood the topic that we are talking about. Now we're going to talk about five stages of team development. We've got five stages. We've got a forming stage, a storming stage, norming stage, performing stage, and adjourning stage. Now we've got five stages of team performance. Now under forming, the first stage, forming stage, that's where, as the word said, forming. That's where the team it is formed. When on an enterprise, they've employed people, different people from different background, whatever. So now forming stage, people is the stage where people get to know each other. They take information about each other, gather impression about each other. That's a comfortable stage where everyone is polite with everyone. They're just meeting these new people. They don't know. They just gather information about this a new person. That is forming stage. Then we go to storming stage now. As the word said, storm. Storming, that's the stage where there's too much conflict. The people, they fight there on that stage. Why? People are fighting. People are fighting for roles. People are fighting for, they've placed you on a position where you're not comfortable in. So now people, they still need to get their what they get to be placed well on the working environment. So one needs to be, wants to be a manager, then they place him on a wrong position. That is why we call this storming. This stage, there's too much tension, there's too much struggle, arguments that okay on storming because of the roles and the responsibilities that are given to these people. So one, they are not, at times the people, they are not comfortable people, they want to lead. They didn't give this person a position to lead. That is why this stage is storming stage. Now, let's go to norming stage now. Now, under norming stage, this stage is the stage where people now, they start to realize that we have to work. The stage where there is a consensus, where there is an agreement. People now, they agree on the roles that they are given. This stage where now the working process starts now. People, they develop a respect for their team members now. They start to work.
I think we are in agreement on that.
And then under performing stage now.
Let's work.
Under this stage, people now, they are aware of their roles, they are aware of the strategies and the aims of the business. Now, the business has now a direction. People, they are working now. People, the leader does not have to go and check whether that group or that team, is it working or what. People, they are working. That's why they call it a performing stage. People are working now. People, they are working towards the goals of the team. Now, the differences amongst the team members, they are appreciated. So people, they perform. That's why we call it what? A performing stage. Then the last stage that we have, we call it an adjourning stage. Adjourning stage, or the other way, it's morning. Now, at this stage, it's when a team, they've met the objectives of the enterprise. There is the completion of the project, if it was a project.
Listen, we just finished the project.
Let's take, for example, the grade 12s. If you're a grade 12, now we are going to write your final examination. That stage, we call it what? A journey stage. The reason why that team, the reason why you were at school, now it's ending. Because you were at school to get that certificate. Now it's the last paper, your last examination. You need to complete everything. You need to ensure that you bring the textbooks of the school and what and what. We call that a morning stage. That's why at times they call it morning stage. People, they feel bad because they're going to break up with your friends. Some people, it's traumatic for them. They don't know what they're going to do just after school. All tasks need to be completed before this stage, the adjourning stage.
And now we are going to talk about the importance of team dynamic theories. Now, you remember at grade 11, we've talked about the theories. We've got how many theories that we have? That we have learned, we've got bell band theory, we've got MTR approach theory, we've got consensus theory, we've got Carl Jungian theories. Now, those are the four theories that we've learned at grade 11. Why were we learning about this theory? It's very important to understand theory, because if you're going to place one work environment, you are going to place that person where be able to maximize the profitability, where that person will feel comfortable with that job. You know the theories, what are the theories say? Let's take Belbin theory. Belbin theory says everyone has a role. Now, you need to identify a role from the individual. You need to know this person. What type of a person is this one? This one's got this role. Maybe this one is the scalper. And now, scalper, those ones who, strategic thinkers, those ones who come with mathematical project, whatever, is a thinker. So now it's very important to place one according to the ability of the person. That's what theory says, Belbin theory. And it's Belbin theory, it's MTR theory, and they are similar. They say roles are important. So now when you employ one, you need to understand what is the role of that person. Maybe this person is a coordinator. Therefore, place this person according to the ability of that person. And okay, again, we've got to Carl Jungian. The theory of Carl Jungian says people are different. People, we've got introvert, we've got extrovert. Now, on an introvert person, when you're going to place that person, you're going to place that person so that that person are comfortable where that person will be working. You know, you're not going to place an introvert person where you're supposed to address an audience where there is too much drama there. He doesn't want to work there. He wants to want a cool environment. Then that person will maximize. That person will excel in what he's doing because you'll be comforted. That's what Carl Jungian says. And then the last theory is consensus. Consensus says there must be an agreement. That's very important. In a team, people, they must agree on goals. They must agree on the objective. They must agree on whatever. Agreement is very important. Agreement makes the profit for the business. So it's very important. So that's why we've learned about the theories. Now, I've said the business need to allocate tasks according to the role that they've seen from that person. And then the business will do what? If you place people well, business will maximize on the profitability. The performance will be good because you are placing people according to their role. And then because of you sit down, you check the role that the person have. Therefore, the strength and the weaknesses of the people, they'll complement each other. And if you understand the personality of the people, there'll be less conflict. Because you are placing people according to what the theory are saying. And then after this theory and after the theories and the teams, we also have a little bit assessment that I would like you to do it on your spare time to see whether you've understood what we've been talking about. Now, as we've been talking about teams, you know, when there are two or more people gathered, definitely there will be conflict.
Lucky that we're at work right now. Ooh.
Now, conflict, what do you understand by a conflict, guys? It's a disagreement. It's a misunderstanding that would arise between that two or more people that are involved in that working in that team.
Fight, 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 fight.
So the business need to come up with ways on how are they going to resolve that those disagreements, how are they going to resolve those conflicts. They need to come, people need to come together, people need to come with a strategies way to resolve conflict. Now, firstly, let's start about the causes of a conflict in a working environment. What would be the cause of the conflict in a working environment? It's that the different backgrounds of people, cultures, beliefs, you know, that could cause a, when you are wearing a spandla, someone doesn't understand, doesn't want to touch you because of that spandla, you know, someone might not understand. Let's take, for example, someone from wherever, an Indian. We'll say this one is doing this. What is happening? You know, one will not understand that you are wearing that because of what. So now different backgrounds could cause conflict, different personalities. One is bubbly, one is very shy, quiet, ignoring of procedures and rules. There are rules. We were told that we need to meet at 12 for a meeting somewhere. One is ignoring that, go and drink tea and come 20 past 11. That could cause conflict in the workplace.
Who do you think you are?
Unfair workload. One is given pile of work and the other one's been given the few work. That could cause a conflict. Lack of cooperation. If one doesn't want to do what is supposed to do, that could cause a conflict. Lack of proper communication. If you don't communicate to people, don't tell people, it doesn't understand what I was supposed to do because of there was no communication. That could cause a conflict. Unrealistic deadline. You expect one to finish a project in 2 days, in whatever, you know? If you come up with deadlines that are not real.
This bathroom's getting finished today because that's what we discussed.
That could cause a conflict. Lack of recognition. What has done well then? You don't give that recognition to that person. That could create a conflict. Yeah. We've got plenty, guys. We've got limited resources in the business. I want to make copies. There are no papers for making copies for my learners for notes. That could cause a conflict. Manage stress. You know that you've got a stress. You don't control that. Nah, there are poor communication, guys. There are many things that could lead to conflict. It's very important for the business to come up with a way on how are they going to deal with it, how are they going to handle that conflict in a working environment.
So, what is the solution?
Firstly, let me explain conflict. It's when a group of people, they are not happy, they are dissatisfied because of what? The government doesn't want to increase the salary. Now, that group of educators, the group of workers, they are not happy because of, they are not given that raise. Therefore, that could cause what? Conflict. Now, if there is a conflict, one on a business must acknowledge that there is a conflict in a working place. Second step, you need to identify the cause of the conflict. You need to arrange negotiations between the conflicting party and the other party. Sit down, try to negotiate terms on how to resolve that. And then you need to arrange meeting with the conflicting parties, the employers and the employees. They need to come down, sit down and come with way on resolving. Make the intentions of both parties clear. Each party has an opportunity to express their opinions, their feeling. Conflicting party must recognize their views. during the meeting. You cannot only concentrate maybe on a management only, on the then neglect the employees. Both parties, we need to sit down and listen to both views of these parties. Blame shifting need to be avoided. You cannot, yeah, it's because of you employees. Yeah, blame shifting doesn't help. You need to have a direction on your meetings. On what is it that, way forward? What is it that you are going to do? Focus on the solution. You need to brainstorm possible ways to resolve the conflict. And then that will be our last part on how to handle conflict in the workplace. Therefore, we've got a little assessment that I'd also like you to do it and check the ability of your understanding. Thank you very much. I appreciate a lot, guys. Thank you very much. Continue subscribing. Thank you for the love. I'm very much happy. Subscribe, view. What is it that you do it?